I'm about to do something that I've never done before and that I am really excited about. You probably already saw it in the thumbnail of this video and you read the title. I am going to be riding in an autonomous car. What am I exactly doing here and what is this video all about? Well, I am here at the headquarters of Baidu and I'm going to be making two videos. In this video, I will be talking about the robo taxi and how that works and I will experience the ride. In the second video, I will be touring the headquarters and I will show you around different areas, a few exhibition halls, other places that they will show us. So if you don't want to miss that video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. If you don't live in China, you might not know about Baidu. The company is often compared to Google because it was originally focused on internet search. But more recently, it's focused on AI, robots, self-driving tech, and smart devices. In this video, I will introduce you to their self-driving robo-taxi named Apollo. I have never actually been in an autonomous vehicle or self-driving car, but I'm really curious to find out if the ride is similar to riding with a human driver. I started making simple travel vlogs 10 years ago, so now I'm here standing in front of Baidu. If you've told me 10 years ago that I would be here at Baidu's headquarters riding one of these cars, I would have never believed you. But here we are. We are here going to hop in these cars. The door's open, I'm gonna hop in. Hey, here we go, we're going. As you can see, there's still a driver in the front seat, and that is all because of security. They're still testing these cars and only a few have been licensed to go out in the street. So for security reasons, there is always a driver next to the driver's seat. Oh, we have people walking here. Oh yeah, it's slowing down, going around it. This is so bizarre. I mean, the ride feels like I'm in a regular car. It would be the same with a driver in the seat. There's just nobody there. It's a bit creepy. I just got out of the autonomous car. It was quite the ride, quite the experience. I have never been in an autonomous car before, so this was a unique experience. It's kind of interesting though, because according to my research, people started to work on autonomous cars already in the 1920s, which is 100 years ago. That might sound crazy, but according to the Freelance Star,
breaking news, one of the most amazing products of modern science will be demonstrated in Fredericksburg next Saturday, June 25th, when the Phantom Auto will be piloted through the streets of the city without a driver or occupant, with no one touching it and no wires or strings attached to it.
This was reported in 1932, but the Phantom Auto was first demonstrated in 1926 on the streets of Milwaukee. I'm sure that was impressive for the time, but it was really just a gimmick because the operators were using remote controls to steer and direct the little cars, really like the children toys that we have right now. It wasn't until the 1980s that we really started to work on designing and developing autonomous cars. In the 1980s, a vision-guided Mercedes-Benz robotic van designed by Ernst Dickmanns and his team at the Bundeswehr University in Munich, Germany, achieved a speed of almost 96 kilometers per hour on the streets without traffic. In the same decade, DARPA funded an autonomous land-driven vehicle project in the United States. The ALV project achieved the first road-following demonstration that used LiDAR, computer vision, and autonomous robotic control to direct a robotic vehicle at speeds of up to 31 kilometers per hour. By 1989, Carnegie Mellon University had pioneered the use of neural networks to steer and otherwise control autonomous vehicles. Fast forward a few more decades and a lot more research, and now I'm here at Baidu, riding in a fully autonomous taxi. While much of the early work was done in the US and Europe, the race to fully AI-driven cars is global, with China and specifically Baidu taking a commanding lead. Baidu Apollo is currently conducting open road fully autonomous vehicle tests in Beijing, Changsha, and California, making new breakthroughs in AI learning, mapping, and autonomous road safety. As we can see, the global competition is heating up, and I couldn't be more excited because this technology will change the way we live. From truck transportation to passenger vehicles, this tech has the potential to reduce accidents, pollution, and vehicle manufacturing. This was my first time riding in an autonomous vehicle, and I hope it isn't my last ride. I really think these types of vehicles will be seen more and more on the streets, and I want to give a big shout out to Baidu for sponsoring this video and experience. So if this is the future of cars and driving, do you think you would ever feel comfortable in a driverless car that just rides on its own, where you don't have to do anything? If you have made it this far into the video, make sure to like it and to comment a secret word, which is moon bear. Riding the autonomous car was really cool. It was such a unique experience. I would love to hear from you what you think. Do you think driverless cars are going to be the future? And if so, would you prefer to be in a driverless car, or do you rather continue driving yourself? I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Make sure to also watch out one of my other videos, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye bye.